Welcome to The Trend Talk. We are your hosts, Marabina Jaimes
and Bel Hernandez. Today, we welcome two talented actors who you're going to love on Fox's new Southern Gothic drama, Filthy Rich. We start out with up-and-comer Benjamin Levy Aguilar.
And then we talk to Alanna Ubach, who you know from Girlfriend's Guide to Divorce, Bombshell with Charlize Theron, and of course, the Oscar-winning movie Coco, where she voiced Mama Imelda.
Don't go away. We'll be right back with our guests, Benjamin Levy Aguilar and Alanna Ubach.
Benjamin Levy Aguilar, or Benjamin Levy Aguilar, was born in Guatemala, where he excelled in soccer and was recruited by the AC Milan soccer youth team. His career in soccer took a little derail due to an injury, but Benjamin, or Benji as we're calling him, who is a black belt in the Israeli self-defense Krav Maga and tactical shooting for evasive driving, once worked for the Guatemalan presidential elections. At 18, he moved to Hollywood to pursue an acting career and soon landed roles on Chicago PD and the short film Spirit, for which he won the Best Actor Award at the Los Angeles Film Awards. He is currently starring in his biggest role to date, one of the leads in the TV series Filthy Rich, which begins airing this fall on Fox.
Ladies and gentlemen, can you believe just how far the Sunshine Network has come? This is the most watched ministry on the face of the earth. Now, folks, I would like for you to meet my two children and my beloved, Margaret Monroe.
Which floor?
Sorry.
That's good.
Bro, do you mind?
Sure, knock yourself out, man.
Nah, dude, don't smoke in front of my kids.
Of course I'm not the only one. I'm Ginger. Apparently, I'm your sister.
My name is Franklin Lee, in-house counsel. And I'll need your letters and your IDs.
You must be Ginger, Antonio, and Jason. Oh, who's this little cherub?
This is my son, Jesus.
Oh, if only somebody could bottle up the smell of little babies.
If anybody could have, it would have been Eugene.
Well, all right then. These are my children, Rose and Eric. Rose.
I'm the senior VP of operations, at least until the dust settles.
Welcome, Benji.
Thank you for having me. That's a really nice introduction. Thank you.
We are so excited to have you. And boy, in your short life, you've already lived an exciting life prior to deciding that you wanted to be an actor. So tell us about where that idea came from. Where did you drum up the idea and where did that passion come after you did the soccer, after you worked for the presidential election, you decided you wanted to act? How did that come about?
Well, you know, growing up, I was always into sports, you know, and I think there was no, in my mind, there was no possibility of like, movies was something that I loved to watch, but there, I didn't know that you could do that, you know, as a career or like, you know, a far-fetched dream, like a big, someone dreaming big in Guatemala is becoming a soccer star, like to play with the greats, you know, that's hard, but it's possible, it's attainable. Hollywood was just like another dimension that I didn't really know about, you know, so I excelled in sports and I did, I was really, I think the death of my father and a lot of other dark, hard moments in my life gave me more fire to like actually try to get out and explore something big in my life. And I think that's where soccer became such a beautiful obsession with me. And then I did Krav Maga for years and I thought I was gonna go to Israel to honor my Jewish heritage. Hollywood came in a spur of the moment, a decision. Like it wasn't like I always wanted to be an actor. I started getting cold feet of leaving and I was like, is this gonna be my life? Like what I need something to look forward to, something that really is gonna challenge me. And my mom said, I think we were getting like our license renewed in Guatemala. And I was kind of depressed at that time. I was not having my, you know, best time. And she was like, what about acting? And I was like, oh yeah. So how do you do that? And she was like, well, I guess you go to like LA or Hollywood. I was like, okay, yeah, that sounds fun, you know? So we actually bought the ticket that day, and I quit my job with, you know, all the security and government stuff, and I didn't submit my papers to Israel, and I jumped on a plane the next week and landed in LAX literally January 1st, 2012, and I started a new life. Yeah.
So the moral of the story is listen to your mom.
Listen to her. I had a really supportive mother, you know? I grew up with a single mother, and I do owe it, you know, all to her, like everything that she gave me, she instilled in me that you can do anything that you love. And anything.
What's her name?
Mariluz Aguilar.
Mariluz.
Yeah.
So we're going to talk a little bit more about Filthy Rich, because this is such a, the trailer looks amazing. It looks like an interesting story. So you play Antonio, an up-and-coming boxer and single dad. So tell us about how you landed the biggest role of your career, Benji.
Wow, so I get excited just thinking about it, because it all feels so new to me. I was a reader for Carla Hull Casting, and I met amazing people there. And I had no reps at that time, and they were auditioning for a short film called Spirit. And they were like, Ben, you do martial arts. Do you want to audition for this? And I was like, yes, absolutely. I would love to. And it was about a fighter cutting weight in 24 hours before a fight. So it had to lose a big amount of weight in like a very short amount of time, which is very normal for fighters, and they don't talk about it that much. And I was so excited that, I mean, I booked it, and I ended up losing like 30 pounds to do this short film in 30 days. And I think Carla and Natalie Ballesteros and Isel Ruiz, when they saw my, I think, work ethic, they were like, we need to refer him to someone. And they referred me to my manager. And he had just taken me on, and it was like 3 weeks into pilot season. It was my first pilot season. And we got this audition, and I remember getting so excited because it was Tate Taylor from The Help, and I had seen that movie. So I auditioned, I got a call back, and when they told me I was going to screen test for it, I thought I had booked it because I didn't know what a screen test was, and I started celebrating. My manager's like, no, hold on, you still have one more audition left. And I went into the screen test with a black eye, because I'd been sparring that week with my, you know, with my training partners and stuff. And I guess it kind of fit the role, but I didn't want them to think that I did it on purpose. You know what I mean? I ended up booking it, and it was just so fast. You know, it just felt like I've been here for 8 years already studying my craft and respecting my craft. But then as soon as it happened, I was in New Orleans 15 days later, you know, shooting. And I think it was just a role that I was meant to play. You know, it was really close to my heart.
Your training as a martial artist really came in handy for this role, because you play a boxer and, as we mentioned before, a dad. But tell us about the dynamics of the family that you belong to in this story. Tell us what the show is about, and who plays your mom and maybe stepmom in this.
Well, the show focuses on a very wealthy Christian conservative family, you know, where the patriarch of the family dies, and when he does, the matriarch of the family, played by Kim Cattrall, is stumbled upon knowing that this man had three illegitimate children from three different women, all from three different backgrounds and cultures, and so these three illegitimate kids, I play one of them, step into this family, and we try to coexist together, you know, everyone wanting different things for different reasons, and everyone's fighting for something really important. So my basically stepmom, or, you know, the matriarch, is played by Kim Cattrall, and my mother is played by Alanna Ubach, and she is, it was such an honor to work with her. Like, genuinely, I learned so much from her. I learned so much from everyone on this show. That everyone took me in, you know, basically under their wing, because they knew I was new to all of this. But obviously, spending so much time with Alanna and seeing her, it was really impressive and, like, inspiring to see. She's amazing. I love her.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm sure you guys are going to be wonderful together because she's so amazing. Of course, we love her from so many shows and Popo and everything.
Like, you don't know what she like she's gonna do or what she's doing, and you don't know when she starts and when she stops. She's just like, I've never seen something like that.
A pro. She's been in it a while, and that's wonderful that she decided to take you under her wing and everybody else, because I bet this was like, you're on the set with all of these people who've been working in this business forever.
I was so lucky to have like everyone just saw me as what I was, which I was new, I was excited. I mean, I put my all of my heart in it, but of course it was my first big experience, and everyone, I really learned so much from every single person on that set, and for that I'm ever grateful.
So yeah. This was your first experience on the big television series. Now, in 5 years, what do you see yourself doing? What is your dream to be doing in 5 years in the industry?
I had such an opportunity to work with incredible people from the beginning, and I want to keep doing just that. I want to work with my heroes. I want to tell amazing stories maybe that haven't been said that are meant to be said. I want to do stories that matter. I want something in maybe more of the selfish aspect. I want to grow more as myself, as a human being. And I think that I finally found a craft or an art outlet for me to understand myself more through the characters that I do. Even when I was in acting class and I'd be doing these roles that maybe reminded me of my father's drug addiction, you know, and when I would step into those roles, I'd understand him more, you know, and I understand myself. And so I really do take this so seriously for me, besides the fact that, you know, all the other great things that come with it. I do see this as an opportunity to grow as for myself and challenge myself. So I just want to work on challenging beautiful, interesting projects.
You know, and we all know, or maybe some of us don't know, that Oscar Isaac is also a Guatemalteco, and he's a wonderful actor who has just made the super crossover. So did you know about him as you were, you know, coming up in Guatemala? Had you heard of him?
Well, to be honest, I actually hadn't heard of him, and I didn't know who he was. But when I started actually looking at movies in a different way and started like looking into like the craft and like great acting and really like seeing these performances, I saw Drive, and I was like, that's amazing. Like, and you know, and a lot of my friends and people would say like, you look a lot like Oscar Isaac. So I started searching him more, started seeing all of his career. And then I stumbled upon, he's born in Guatemala. And I'm like, I can't even, you know, so he became an inspiration later on because it seems close to me. And, you know, I had never seen any other actor, a Guatemalan actor ever. I had never seen that. So he gave me like an extra push to like be like, oh, I want to do something like that, because all the roles he does are just so beautiful and so different and not stereotypical, you know, right. like sometimes we've played before.
Well, you're an amazing young man. We look forward to your continued success in Filthy Rich and all the other things that you want to do.
Thank you so much
for joining us on the Trend Talk. And everyone else, don't go away. We'll be right back with our special guest. You know our next guest from the Oscar-winning film Coco as Mama Imelda. She gave a stellar performance as Jeanine Perrault opposite Charlize Theron in Bombshell. And you also know her as Susie Howard in the popular show Euphoria. You are soon going to be seeing her in the upcoming Fox series, Filthy Rich, which stars Kim Cattrall. Welcome, Alanna.
Encantada. Encantada.
So wonderful to meet you virtually anyway. Yes. I have already met Yopi Candelaria.
Yes, you have. You watched it. 3 episodes, yes, so far.
Yes. And you played such a wide range of roles. I mean, here you are playing Imelda, which is an enchanting role in Coco, where you actually sang, and La Llorona.
Y aunque la vida me cueste llorona, no dejaré de quererte, no dejaré.
a tough as nails, a woman who is quite interesting. And at first, you don't know who she is. And then just at the end of the third episode, I started to, oh, I see. So tell us a little bit about your character.
Well, it's interesting. I mean, in order to sort of shake things up a bit, she has found out that her ex-lover slash baby daddy is now deceased. And the fact that my son is on that will is, to me, like winning the lotto. And I base this character on my father, who was such a hustler. He was the biggest hustler I ever met. And so ballsy. And so charismatic, but she tends to get in her own way. And that's what I find fascinating about her. And so she decides to shake up this family that is portrayed as, to the public, this very in control, beautiful, faith-oriented family. And when you peel all of the layers, you find out that there are so many secrets and there's so much repugnance behind this facade. And she is one of the people, one of the proprietors of peeling those layers. And that's what I find so fascinating about her.
You know what I find about the series itself is the religion and how they approach it, because they don't downplay or cast any aversions on any side, whether you're religious or not. But within that, you see the inconsistencies of sure. people on both sides.
Absolutely. And how sometimes how faith to think that these people that were believers in Christianity, such strong believers, and that they made a business out of it. And the business grew to become this empire worth billions. And I think that's something that is fascinating, because you see the juxtaposition of something that is faith-based, but the amount of money and chaos behind the curtain is astounding.
But you know, Kim Cattrall's character, at least in the first three episodes, yes. it just seems like she really does believe everything about her religion. Who knows
absolutely.
What we're going to find out? But
well, absolutely she does, and her faith, her integrity is basically what kept that business going. So as the matriarch of something like that, to get such a slap in the face when her husband is deceased, to find out that he was a womanizer and that he had all of these illegitimate kids, is such a slap in her faith-based face. Mm-hmm. And a blow to any kind of, I'm sure, belief that she had in the past about being true to your partner, and his infidelities is the most human thing that has happened to her, I'm sure, in a long time.
Yes.
We get to see both sides of the coins. So do
yes,
not
we
miss
do.
Out on Filthy Rich.
That is right.
But speaking of matriarchs, we want to talk to you about wonderful Benjamin Levy Aguilar,
yes.
who plays your son, and we also had the pleasure of interviewing him. So in the show, he is a boxer. And you're his trainer. Tell us about this.
Okay. Benjamin's character is technically a superhero in a way, because he is so profoundly talented in the ring. And it is my job to push the buttons that I have installed in order to get him carbonated so that he can win every fight. So in spite of the fact that he is very innocent and he is very integrity based, it's up to me to protect that outside of the ring and bring it to the surface, all of his pain externally, to bring it to the surface so that he can use that rage and that pain in the ring, and only in the ring, fortunately.
Wow. So it was an interesting take on the mother. Like I said, I didn't realize it. I'm like, oh my gosh, that's the mom. Anyway, we won't give away any of the other little character little tweaks that you have.
Sure.
But I wanted to talk to you about yourself. You're a mother.
Yes.
How do you juggle? Because women always need to get that right balance between family and work. How do you do it?
To juggle a career and a child at the same time. I had him very late in the game. He is my one and done, we call him. He's my miracle baby. I was pregnant when I was 41. I didn't think I could get pregnant. So to actually every single moment, my husband and I devour with this child because he's so special. And he doesn't have very many cousins. They're all much older. So he doesn't have any contemporaries to really play with. So he's constantly surrounded by adults and has really taken on this role of this very worldly little boy. He's now 3 years old, and it's just such a joy. This pandemic has, one way or another, has caused me to be at home constantly. And while this is happening, it's wonderful because I started working the moment I gave birth to him. I was working like a month later. I was going to New York and FedExing my breast milk to him. It was crazy. And I thought, I can do this. I can do everything. And to finally be sort of forced to slow down and stay at home is a wonderful gift in a way, because now I can really watch him grow and learn and develop into this amazing little human being. It's quite fascinating. But I use him in every role I play because he's always the gasoline to every car that I'm in every show.
I absolutely understand that. I also have a son. He's 18 now, but
18.
But I wanted to tell you, Alanna, you know, of course, everyone knows you from Coco. That was a film for all ages. But of course, you do also come from children's television. And we have someone very special in common, Mark Ritz.
Ah, you're kidding me. Yes.
Well, wonderful Mark played, of course, the funny lab rat on Beekman's World.
Mark Ritz played the lab rat in Beekman's World, which was a show I did many, many years ago. I was 16 years old. He was a Harvard grad student. He helped me write all of my entrance essays to every college I was trying to get into. So I have such a place in my heart for Mark.
Well, I had the pleasure of working with him and winning Emmys with him as well on Storytime because he was, you know. So we have that in common.
Oh my gosh, bless him.
Yes, we have great, great memories of him. And of course, we have a lot of people walking around with mustaches that saw us as they were growing up. So I don't know if this happens to you, but I always, every so often I get a, "Hi, Mara, it was really nice to grow up watching you." So I'm sure you get a lot of that too.
Oh, it's unbelievable. I mean, you know, I've been doing this for such a long time, and I'm going to be 45 soon. So to actually have someone come up to me and say, "You were my babysitter technically when I was a child. You were Josie on Beekman's World, and you taught me everything I needed to know about snots and what is a cold. Dear Beekman, what is... you know, what is a pimple?" It's so exciting for me to know that.
Well, this is amazing. I am so glad to meet you. And also you have another thing in common with Marabina. You both are Mexican Puerto Rican.
What?
We're Mexican.
Tú eres un combinación de Puerto Rico y México.
That's right. Yo entro mexicana y salgo puertorriqueña.
¿Y de qué parte en el país? ¿Tu mamá es de México? Sí.
My mother, may she rest in peace. She passed away recently. But my mother was from Cotencatl, Tamaulipas, and my father was from San Juan, Puerto Rico.
Ah, sí, mi padre es de San Juan, mi mamá es de Sinaloa.
Sí, we'll have to have a coffee.
Gangster town. Yes, we will. She moved here when she was 3. And my father came out here when he was 19. And, you know, growing up, he passed away many years ago. And when he passed away, I thought, one day I will play a role that is based on him entirely. And this is it.
Wow. Well, that's exciting. We got to tell everyone how and when to tune in, because we got to see this role. I've already seen you in it. You're amazing. The show is really good. It really draws you in. So tell us, where can we reach you? Where can we see this show, this fabulous show?
Every Monday at 9 o'clock, please tune in to Filthy Rich, starring Kim Cattrall. It is beyond anything I have ever seen. It has everything, including the kitchen sink, that has anything to do with drama with a wink. What I love so much about it is it reminds me of all the great shows that I grew up watching in the 1980s, como Dallas y Dynasty, and Knots Landing.
Ooh, a new
everyone
novela.
Is not, yes.
It really is
a novela, sí.
It's a telenovela on steroids with religion and money involved.
Yes, gotta watch it.
Oh my gosh, you said it the best. You said it the best. It really is. And I think people are very hungry right now for a lot of content, and especially la gente, right? We love passionate characters that are very multi-layered. And just when you think this character is going to do something, they do something completely different and shock us. And it's something that you can't get enough of. I'm very excited about Filthy Rich.
Alanna, we absolutely look forward to tuning into Filthy Rich. Give Benji a squeeze from us. We're his madrinas.
Thank you. Cyber abrazos y besos. ¿Sí?
Yes, thank you so much. And everyone else, don't go away. We'll be right back with our Trend Talk Trendsetter shout out.
Today, we give a Trend Talk Trendsetter shout out to Benny the Jet Urquidez, a legendary moving force in martial arts for over 5 decades, a 6-time world champion in 5 weight class divisions. Urquidez pioneered full contact fighting in the United States. If you want to learn more about this legendary martial artist, go to BenedictJet.com.
Thank you for joining us, and don't forget to follow us on the Trend Talk Show. And remember, if it's trending, we're talking.